get in.
Look, up in the sky, it's a bird.
No, Walt, I'm getting out of here.
It's a plane.
Yeah.
It's Steve Harvey.
Name something that most men do not do as well as they think they do. Tiffany.
Wipe themselves when they use the restroom.
Well, we got top seven answers on the board. Name something a doctor might pull out of a person. Darcy.
A gerbil. No. I've heard about something like that once.
Yes, you said it. Let me just write out like that.
That's awesome.
Name something a doctor might pull out of a person. Bam! Gerbil! Miss Sharon, name something on your body you glad you only had one of.
My butthole, Steve.
Something on your body you're glad you only had one of?
Vagina, Steve.
Jesus.
Good answer!
But you thought after butthole.
Hey!
You thought since butthole was up there, you just gonna just go down the line?
Yes, Steve.
Vagina. Megan, tell me something you put in your mouth but you don't swallow.
Wow.
You ever walked up to somebody and saw the look on their face and you just know? I walked up to her and I went, whoa. Name something, Joe, that squirts when you least expect it.
Well, Steve, at my age, my privates.
That's what I got. Get that. The hell is that bad? It's privates. Yeah! Top 200 men. Name the first part of a woman you touch to get her in the mood. Let's quit playing, Larry.
That would be the lower front or the vagina.
Thank you.
a year, which is a wellness exam. Yes.
So let's a wellness exam.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
A checkup.
Yes, sir.
There you go. Here you go.
What part of the patient?
Okay, well, let's say the vagina.
It's TV, Steve. It's TV, Steve. Let's go. Woo! That better be checked once a year. Better be checked once a year. Let's go. Let's go. Bing. Hey, Tammy.
Hello.
If your dog got into the Viagra, name something in your house that wouldn't be safe.
I'm going to say your vacuum cleaner hose.
Oh.
Name something you pull out.
Your penis.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
All right, let's turn around.
Can I rub your head for good luck?
Can you rub my head for good luck? I don't.
Please.
Ma'am?
Okay. Okay.
You got no strikes, Gene. You got one answer left. If it's there, you clear the board, my man. We talked to 100 men. What would you do if you received an obscene phone call from a woman?
What would I do, or what would 100 men do?
Hey, my man.
Masturbate.
I'm just saying 100 men, not me. I'm thinking. From a woman. Man from a woman, right? Not me. 100 men. You're asking me, right? And not me, Steve.
Name something that follows the word pork.
You pine.
Huh?
Huh? You pine. Pork is pine.
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer! Woo! Yes!
Name something someone might hand you at a wild party.
Hors d'oeuvres.
Hors d'oeuvres.
That's right.
What's the name of that school you went to? Again? What's the name of that school? Come
Oswego
in?
State University. Yeah. That's one
having
of them.
Wild parties down there passing out them damn hors d'oeuvres. Woo! I was up on them hors d'oeuvres. I couldn't take another hors d'oeuvre. Girl, you give me one more hors d'oeuvre, I'm going to turn this damn party out. Understand? Boy, they had up in there, man. We had beers, we had hors d'oeuvres. Woo! We was in there, woo! Clowning. Cornelius at his parties, they was at wild parties, passing out hors d'oeuvres. Oh, yeah. Name something that might get in the way when you're kissing.
Mustache.
Good answer.
You know, Miss Ruby, you just gonna stare at me. You see how she was coming today? Yo damn mustache.
Well, I try to keep it clean.
I'm telling you,
try
man.
To keep it clean.
Oh, the mustache! Jennifer, name something and make it in a way when you're kissing.
I'm going to say big lips.
You want them slapping all over your face, you know.
Nah. Tell me something that you dread about going to the doctor.
Getting undressed.
Getting undressed. That gown.
Yes.
Never fits. It's open.
Yes.
Yeah, I have fun with mine.
I'm sure you do.
Put mine on in the front, and I don't tie it. You gotta have fun with
it. I'll do that next time.
Yeah,
I'll
don't
try
let
that.
It be
okay.
Such a. Make it trying for them.
Good answer. See,
don't you sit
there
over there and go through the embarrassment. Embarrass them.
Thank you.
Don't put it on. Just leave it folded next to you. Just be sitting on that tissue, just naked. Yeah. How you doing, Doc? How's everybody? Come on in.
And as part of my job, Steve, I have to do prostate exams. And
you have to do what?
Prostate exams. Part of what I do is
you
part
do
of
the prostate exam?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolutely.
Where your office at?
Come out to East New York, Brooklyn.
Ladies and gentlemen, my new doctor.
Well, I love you so much.
Do you?
Oh my God, yes. Oh my God, I've been wanting to do this so bad. Oh my God. You like it? You like it, baby? You can scratch too. I watch you all the time, every day. I do not miss you at all. And I got, oh my God, here it comes.
You gotta let him go.
Sure.
I hope so, because I tell you, I really do, Steve. I love you to death.
Well, Miss Norma, I love you.
Oh, good.
Girl, I gotta tell you, matter of fact, I don't think I've ever been loved this much before.
Oh, God. Yeah, Lord, I could just go on and on and just love you. Oh, I'm rubbing your back. Oh, give me a muscle.
We gotta be quiet. Come on. Yeah. Yeah. We gotta pray. Mama, we gotta pray. Okay.
She was telling me to let you go.
Please take this answer. I don't care. Killing me. I'm dying.
That's one more time.
They're touching me. They're whispering things to me you can't hear. Okay, I'm trying. Some men are pigs. What barnyard animal might you compare your man to?
A camel.
What barnyard? No. What desert-dwelling animal might you compare your man to?
Camel.
You stop pointing.
You're sticking with it. You're sticking with it.
Camel. Name a word starting with B that describes Kim Kardashian's penis.
Bougie.
What?
Bougie.
No.
Bougie.
Yeah, that's what I want to hear. I want to hear what the hell you said at first. One more time.
Bougie.
The old whole family from the hood. Hey, Leland, how you doing?
I'm all right, man. How you doing?
Good, good. What you do for a living?
Well, I'm a father, single father of three kids. Lovely Cassandra, Leland Jr.
Oh, you're a single father?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, I'm going to get you somebody today.
I ain't legal yet, but when I am legal, any of y'all that look good can call.
Listen to me, Leland, listen to me. You ain't been out there in a while.
No.
See, you've been having three kids, you've been married, so you're a little bit deep.
Yeah.
You can't go into it looking thirsty.
All right.
But anybody out there, all y'all that look good can come to see me. Women just going, Hey, Leland, we talked to 100 men. Name something that rises when it gets hot.
Your sexual parts, man.
Yeah, that's what I thought you was going to say.
Hey, hold on.
Miss Jackie, you knew that the little nasty Leland was going to be the first one to get it. I was bound to come out. I knew it was going to be Leland, though. Doggone shame. Sexual parts. Name something you shouldn't leave out in the open at your house when people come to visit.
Your dildos.
Oh.
Well, y'all heard it, didn't you? Pick them up. All this out on the coffee table and all this stuff in here on the kitchen table. And who laid this on the plate? Randy, only one strike, man. What would you do if you noticed your boss forgot to zip up his fly?
Zip it up for him.
Name something you could tell needs to be replaced just by the smell.
Air freshener?
Let me just go to the board. I can't work. I can't figure out what you mean by that. Air freshener! Brenda?
Yes, Mr. Harvey.
I'm so sorry because I just knew good and hell well that wasn't that good. Name a place Grandpa goes with his Viagra. Francesca.
Golfing.
Golfing. Well, if he can do that, I'm gonna have to get some of that. He took his Viagra. Name a place that Grandpa goes with his Viagra.
A house of ill repute.
Grandpa. The house of ill repute. Oh, we're going to hell for this one right here.
Maybe.
All right, Amy. No, ain't no doubt about it. I can feel it. Name a place Grandpa goes with his Viagra.
He goes in his car parking in the Overlook.
Is it DeQuil?
It's DeQuil.
DeQuil, how you doing? What
I'm
are you
good,
doing, man?
I'm good. I'm a business consultant for a information systems company.
All right, DeQuil, we're going.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to ask the same question.
Okay.
Again, try not to look like you making this up.
Okay.
All right, DeQuil. So what do you do for a living?
I'm a business consultant for a... for information systems company.
Yeah, that's you. Yeah.
Okay.
DeQuil, that's now officially a lie.
All right.
Okay. Miss Margaret. What does he do?
That's my firstborn.
Yes, ma'am. And what does he do?
He is a consultant.
Name something you might do while in the shower.
Urinate, Steve.
Yeah. Let it go.
Yeah. Say something.
Say time.
I ain't tripping on that answer. I don't know. You can sit here and act like you don't, but whoo, I find it refreshing. Urinate! Name something Shaquille O'Neal has that's bigger than yours.
I'm gonna go with hands.
He's got, well, that's a body part. That's a body
I'm gonna
part.
Go with junk.
That's all body parts? That's totally separate. I got news for you. When a guy refers to the little... I got to tell you, I know you're the judge here, but I just got to tell you, that's a totally separate item. That's handled differently. It's set aside differently. It's cared for. It's protected with our life. All right, here we go. Top 8 answers on the board. Can you reach it? Okay. What do you do, darling?
I am a homemaker, and I have 2 children, and I make my own bread and raise chickens. Well, 3 chickens, not really a ton of them.
Now, let's talk about them chickens, though. You raise chickens.
I raise 3 chickens. Mm-hmm. We named them. They're pretty much pets. And we just get their eggs. Yeah, we don't
eat
them.
Eat the eggs.
We eat chicken, but we don't eat these chickens.
Oh, no, yes. No, I was on a different farm. If you don't lay enough eggs, then...
You become dinner.
We frying you. I had chickens in there just cranking eggs out. How you doing, Mr. Harvey? Yeah. Name an occupation where someone wears a robe at work. Aaron.
What is a surgeon?
You thought we were playing Jeopardy?
For a second. Just for a second.
What was your answer? No one's never asked me a question back. I don't understand your answer.
I said
a surgeon.
A surgeon.
Oh. What is a surgeon? Rob, tell me something a farmer's wife might accuse him of caring more about than her.
His farm equipment.
The farm... More specific.
His... hoe?
I kid you not. I couldn't have wrote a joke better than that. That's the best damn answer I've ever heard as the host of Family Feud. No,
I really appreciate it.
That's damn brilliant.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you.
It ain't up there, but that is the best. Damn answer that ain't on the board I've ever heard. We asked 100 married women, if you could change one part of your husband's body, what would it be? Joyce?
His penis. His penis.
His penis.
There's a theme.
Your other answer was just like that.
I know, I come from a weird place sometimes. You were thinking it.
I was thinking it. I wasn't thinking a damn thing. I don't know your husband, but I think that's him with that happy town. He's having a rough day. This penis. Name something from the kitchen you can use to get something cooking in the bedroom.
Gravy.
What's up, though? Gravy. You'd be amazed.
Imagination.
But then he did this. Hey. Pour a little bit out there. You'd be, hey. That boy learned something down at that college, ain't he? Gravy. All right, we ask 100 men, name something you do when you realize you run out of clean underwear.
Right. You get them from your wife, her drawers, her underwear.
You wear your wife's drawers?
If you're out.
You said you wear your wife's drawers. That's what you said. There's nothing to do with dirty underwear. That's a whole nother game. Shauna says that you just wear... your wife's drawers. I'm not even turning around. Name a place
people get romantic because there's a risk factor of getting caught. Miss Myrtle?
Church!
Huh? Pastor got the banging congregation, yeah. Folks. We going down there this Sunday. Going down to Pastor Nim Church. Top five answers on the board. Name a word or phrase that starts with pot.
Potato.
Potato.
Good answer.
It does.
Why y'all clapping?
Does it start with pot?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Yes, ma'am, it starts with pot. But we all know. No one says potato. It starts with pot. You know, the Potomac starts with pot. I'm going to just start walking towards
okay.
the Scott family.
Okay.
Nothing personal. I just want to just
okay.
get a jump on it.
Yeah, okay.
Let's see if it's up there. Potato. I'm sorry.
See, you were going to walk away from me.
You're older, you know more than I do. Forgive me, please.
A wise woman.
Name a word or phrase that starts with pot.
Let's go with pot called the kettle black.
Pot called the kettle black.
Good answer, good
answer. Hey, the
good
way this is going, who knows? Pot called the kettle black. Talk to 100 married men. Name something of yours that your friends make fun of.
Manhood. I got some mean friends.
Well, I'm a man. I ain't got no friends I done showed it to. So. Hey, fellas. Hey, you want to see something? You're mad, her brother Steele. Name something a female magician might pull a rabbit out of.
Well, Steve, she may have to bend down and just pull it from under her skirt.
Woo! Go there!
That's up there. Yep. That's up there, Steve. That's up there, man.
It's up there. She got to pull it out of the skirt.
Y'all ready for my grand finale? Yeah, Bob, reach up. Man, I done had it in here for a while. I hope it's still living. Pull a rabbit, snatch a rabbit out your skirt.
All right, Brian, name something a guy might have in his wallet that he wouldn't want his wife to find.
A receipt of him, from him getting, buying something or being somewhere he wasn't supposed to be. So a receipt of it.
Good answer.
A receipt of being, buying something and being somewhere. The receipt for being in something and buying something. Just a receipt. A receipt. Name something you'd never want to see your father wearing. Angela.
Bikinis, draws, women lingerie.
You can't name all of that stuff. A man might dream of having two wives. Yes. Okay, here we go. Let me finish the question. A man might dream of having two wives, but then he'll also have two what? You can't play no more. This game called Family Feud just ain't hit the buzzer. This damn mic won't come on. Well, tell me a traffic sign that best describes your love life.
Okay, I already have two kids, so this is okay for me to say, slippery when wet.
Oh, no!
Stop it. Stop it. We are trying to stay on the air. Little Miss Fast thing over here. Slippery when it's wet. Name something a man would be embarrassed to admit he likes to do in the bathtub.
Play with himself.
Don't know if I'm embarrassed to let you know he plays with himself in the bathtub. Tell me something a man has that he likes to polish.
His man part. Yeah, that's good. I mean, not that I know from experience or anything.
Shut up. His man part.
Lipstick. Yeah. We have that.
Edible lipstick?
Yes, edible lipstick. Kissable lipstick.
Yes.
You lick it off, suck it off. I mean.
Look at your mama looking upside your head.
But I'm 27.
Girl, what you on TV talking about licking and sucking for? You know I raised you better than that. Say you suck again. Say you suck again. Edible lipstick. Give me something a hospital nurse might threaten to do to a misbehaving male patient.
I'm going to give you an enema. Enema.
But what is this photo?
Right
up in there.
Enema.
I'm a jam this thing right here. I swear to God, I'm gonna throw it.
Enema.
I'm gonna make you bend over. I'm gonna be across the room and I'm gonna straight in there.
Exactly.
Enema.
How about not tie the back of his gown?
Not tie the back of your gown. I personally don't really care. I leaves mine open. And when the doctor leave me in there too long, you know how they put you in that room and they don't come by? I go out in the hallway. I get everybody's attention. I see somebody up the hallway, I turn and ask for a doctor. I do. I've done it about 4 times. They get the doctor to your room right away. Hey, name something that an 80-year-old man who marries a 20-year-old woman might need.
I'm a church-going woman.
Wow.
But I would think he might possibly have a rather large member. I don't know.
What church you go to? Blown crazy. The man with the whatever she said. Hey, when a woman isn't pretty, people always say she has a good what?
Real side.
Oh, I know exactly what you mean.
I know you do.
But you threw the judge into something.
A behind.
It, that's just two ways that way. It goes like this.
Nah,
then
you
go, fuck.
Yeah.
And then it's a hook back. Fuck. That's what they're looking for. A nice rear end. Jennifer, only one strike. Name something the man of your dreams has that sadly your husband does not.
I'm going to say, plug yours, Mom. Big.
Package. Hey, Wesley, name something a man sees his wife buy that makes him nervous.
Dildo.
You asked the question.
Good answer. Good answer.
A dildo. Name a way you like your desserts and your men.
Hard.
Super cool Uncle Ray, better known as the Quiet Storm. Name something about Peter Pan that's different from the average boy.
Make good peanut butter.
Name something you wish your hubby would do just in the bathroom, not everywhere.
Men are often moving themselves around, adjusting themselves. In public, you see them walking down the street. They do.
Name something a cowboy does to his woman and his horse.
Michael.
He rides them, Steve. Come on, baby. Number one, he rides them.
Name something you've considered paying money to get rid of.
Your children.
Your children! Rick,
your spouse.
You're going in.
Not me. Not me. Attorney fees.
Damn, Nancy Grace gonna be busy as hell. Kevin?
Steve?
Tell me the last thing you stuck your finger in.
My wife, Steve. It's up there, Steve.
That's my boy, Steve.
You say it's up there.
It's up there, Steve.
Yeah, okay. You okay, man? Number one! Kale?
Yes, sir?
I've had a lot of good answers.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's my favorite answer of all time. Don't do that no more. Ryan?
Yes, sir.
Tell me the last thing stuck your finger in.
No, sir.
Say no, sir. No, sir. No, we are on. No, sir. All these is exits. All this is exits. Listen to me. Let's get this straight. Let me talk to your Carlisle family right now.
Oh, wow.
See these answers up here? Your objective, once you see one, is to guess the one that ain't turned over yet. We don't need y'all reading what's on the board. Most of these people have an education.
We got it.
Sometimes you gotta go over the rules. Name a rumor a woman might spread about her ex-boyfriend just so no other woman will date him. Cicely.
He's a womanizer.
He's a womanizer. Melissa?
He's a cheater.
Amazing how that came to you like that. It's you almost just were bam, that just came.
Good answer, like that.
Okay. Well,
how you doing today?
I'm well, how are you?
All right, what do you do again?
I'm an executive assistant at a paint company. It's Bear Paint. It's pretty big.
Oh, Bear big.
Bear's big.
Oh, Bear is the biggest brand at Home Depot.
It's sold exclusively at Home Depot.
Because you know how I know? Because Home Depot is in my top three stores.
I believe you.
were you just trying to move the show along?
Well, I don't want to forget my answer.
Oh, okay.
Well, there you go.
Excuse me.
Good answer.
A large part of this show is the interview. You know, your answer could be up there, might not. These interviews is priceless. That's what has made this show what it is. You know,
that's right.
I've done what no other host does. I actually talk to people.
Amen.
Obviously, Arlene ain't funny. You need to just come on before I forget my answer. That's nice and good, but I need to remember this answer. All right, Arlene, we ask 100 women, is bad if your eyes, your man's eyes open doing a kiss is worse if he's looking at what?
His mother. It says mama.
Okay,
it says mama. Yeah, whose mom is that? His mama.
It says my mom.
Okay.
See, mom, that.
It covers all the mothers?
It covers all the mothers.
So that's the answer you wanted to hold
on
to? So I can't interview because you're going to say something that's on the board.
Oh!
That's the answer we've been waiting on, Arlene. Well, I just think you need to think of something else. Okay, we ask 100 women. It's bad if your man's eyes are open during a kiss. It's worse if he's looking at what?
Another man.
Wouldn't be good.
Okay, that's different, but it could be number one.
Yeah!
Another man.
It could be number one.
Peter!
We ask 100 women, it's bad if your man's eyes are open during a kiss. It's worse if he's looking at what?
Another woman.
That's number one.
Number one.
Good answer,
it's number
one.
You like that answer?
Do you like it?
Yeah. I mean, if you like it, just tell me.
Yes.
Okay, so now, I'm going to turn, and I'm going to point to another woman.
Okay.
Okay. But if you just stay with me. Mm-hmm. Matter of fact, I tell you what, I'm going to let you point to it first. Say another woman and then point.
Another woman.
Yeah, not a...
Oh.
Well, she did.
I'm trying to stay with you because I know you're trying to help me.
No, I'm just saying, just point at the board.
Oh.
Yeah, that's her number one. Name a reason why someone might leave a house through a window.
They lock themselves in the house with the bolt lock, the extra lock on top.
I'm just remembering what I've seen on the board. And I'm gonna just check a little something out. Yep, sure is. It's different? Okay, you said you lock yourself in. I don't know how different. Maybe you spell lock with two K's. Name something people complain is clingy.
I always have a kid hanging from my legs because I have 5 children. So your children, your kids.
Yeah, that's a great answer. That's good. Woo, that's good. Surprise.
Yeah, it is.
Boy, I love this boy right here.
I'm waiting, Steve.
No, let me go ahead. I love this boy right here. You know, everybody in here in on this one.
J.E. You standing there waiting on it. Is it up there? Folks, is it up there?
Yeah!
Steve, hurry up, man!
Steve, look at the board!
Besides family, name someone rich people might leave money to in their will.
Their relatives?
Yeah. I know that. These some nice people right here. Bob and Karen are nice people. Lady could be my mama. I don't want to just tell her no. I know relatives is family. I know that. It's in the question. Yeah, but what you want me to do? You want me to just tell her that ain't up there? I got to find a kinder way to do it. Miss Karen. Besides family, somebody other than relative.
Universities or schools?
There you go.
Yeah.
Universities or schools? Here we go. Name something of yours that your dog eats, and all you can do is wait for it to come out the other end.
A piece of jewelry.
Piece of jewelry. Patrice, name something of yours that your dog eats, and all you can do is wait for it to come out the other end.
My diamonds?
Good answer. Good answer.
It's a great answer. Outstanding. Damn. How in the world did you ever think of that? Girl, you so crazy. You ready, Catrice? Okay, just go ahead and read the board.
Okay.
Read the board.
All right.
You looking at
it? I'm looking at it.
Do you see it up there anywhere?
You know what? I have faith.
Yeah. Ooh. Mm-hmm. You right there.
It's up there.
It's up there?
Number six.
Really?
Really. Watch this.
Oh. No. You watch this.
Okay.
What's your answer, Gee?
Diamonds.
Diamonds?
My diamonds,
my
yes.
Diamonds. Yeah, go ahead. You shut up. All right, number one.
Oh.
Give me a word or phrase that means naked.
Can I say naked?
Jay, name a part of your body that might hit you in the face when you're bouncing on the trampoline.
I'm gonna say your thighs.
Your thighs! The same as your leg. They're gonna put that on all on the whole leg thing. Leg, knee, all that. Same.
All right, I'm gonna say your shoulder.
Yeah, well, that's good, but you... They already said.
Okay, I'm gonna say your fingers.
Yeah.
Let me guess, you're going to say your arm next, right? And then after that, Jay, you might as well say your damn hair. Just get your stomach in there too, Jay. Let's say, hey, I got them. Your milk jugs. How about that? All right, Jay, we got them all out the way, buddy. Let's go. Name part of your body that might hit you in the face when you're bouncing on a trampoline.
Shoulders.
That's all right, honey.
We gonna go down here one more time. Jay, you can't say nothing else that's on this damn board. I've never seen a person get more wrong answers on just his turn. This just Jay's turn. Jay, I'm gonna stand next to you.
Because, man, obviously, and it's the reason they put you way down here in the fifth spot. They knew. But Jay, come on, man, because we could do this, man. All come right. On. On TV, man. You right. Think, right. Think about it. You out on that Harley and you're riding. God, boy, you sweating hard as hell. Come on, hang in there, Jay. Jay, let me tell you something. Let's take another shot. You're going to read it with me. Name a part of your body that might hit you in the face when bouncing on the trampoline.
I'm going to say your tail end.
I like your ass.
All right. Your ass.
That's what we going with. You done jumped, bam, in your face. Do you know how big your ass got to be for you to jump and then somebody's That's the best answer I heard, Jay. Man, thank you for coming, Jay. You just made my whole day. Your tail end. Name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear.
Your mouth.
Your mouth. Uncle Jesse, name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear.
Your mouth.
Yeah, that's a good one. Bam! Boom! Got to nail it. Fly that plane, boy. What a good answer. Go on, Jesse. That's a good answer there, Jesse. No, I got this. No. I got, let me do this right here. I like people like this. That's just why I come to work. I know you want me to stop taking out this misery, but just let me, please, Monique. Please, I know you won't say it because you love it. Sometimes when you meet crazy people, what you gotta do is you gotta let them go all the way out. You gotta let them, when you see them, let them go, boy. He said, no. Monique, I know you want to save me, because you can't stand to see it, can't. Because you know why you can't stand to see it? Because you know this is on tape. Uncle Jesse, what's your answer again, Jesse?
Your mouth.
Your mouth. That was born as a good answer. Jesse, let me ask you something over there.
Yes, sir.
You really believe that's up there, don't you?
I believe so. It should be.
It should be? What a good answer. Let me ask you something. How you gonna feel if it ain't up there? About that small? Well, I think you're about to feel maybe this small. I know, Miss Monique. I know you won't stop. You ready, Jess?
I'm ready.
All right. Name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear. You're gonna stay with that. All right. Cool. That's what I need. Yeah. Come here, Uncle Jess. Come here. Come here. No, don't talk to me. Sit right there. Number three. Get your ass over there. Oh, I let him go. I let him have all that. Monique was over here dying. She was saying, Mr. Harvey, please.
Please, sir.
Oh, no, I love moments like this.
Showtime.
All right, Jesse, let's try it again. Name a part of your body that makes sounds others can hear.
Your feet.
When a man swims in cold water, his package shrinks from the size of zucchini to what vegetable?
Olive.
Olive. Olive. Joe?
Baby carrot.
A baby carrot.
A dill pickle.
A cherry tomato.
Baby corn on the cob.
I'm going to say broccoli.
I'm going to say a grape.
All right, just help me out a little bit. Yeah. I don't know. I wasn't paying attention in school. A grape is a vegetable? Fill in the blank. I know I just woke up in hell because blank is lying in bed next to me.
Well, Steve, I'm gonna go ahead and say my spouse.
Good answer!
Good answer!
My spouse!
Good answer!
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go!
You got everybody in here looking at each other. Name something Grandma starts doing that might make Grandpa turn off his hearing aid.
I'm just going to say they're having... She's a little too loud in the bedroom. Well... I was saying, okay, she's moaning too loud.
She's moaning too
yes,
loud.
Yes.
Who?
Grandma.
Oh, Grandma is moaning so loud.
I just didn't want to, you know, say it.
You didn't.
It's
I
a
didn't,
little
I didn't
PG.
Want to
it's over the PG rating.
Damn, Alex. Grandma was moaning. Boy, name a rumor a woman might spread about her ex-boyfriend just so no other woman will date him.
He ain't packing down low.
He ain't packing down low. He ain't packing. Tell me something that makes your husband cry.
When your mother-in-law is coming over.
Baby, my mom's coming over. What's he coming over for? Mother-in-law coming. A kiss is just a kiss until the other person does what?
Bites me.
Bite? Yeah. 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 Oh, yeah. We've graduated now.
Yeah.
Tell me a reason your husband probably wouldn't get much work as a fashion model.
He's fat.
He's fat. A fat cow. Ladies, why y'all laughing at that really hard? Women love that. You're right. He's a fat cow. Name something that men do in public that women should be able to do also.
Scratch themselves.
Scratch themselves. Yeah. It's bad if your man's eyes are open during a kiss. It's worse if he's looking at what?
An ass.
An ass. Robin, now the grandpa discovered grandma was cheating when he found other guys what under the bed?
I'm going to say depends.
Damn.
Good answer, good answer.
His depends. Give me a way your husband reminds you of a bear.
He plays with balls, Steve.
Good answer, Dad. Good answer. Good answer, Dad.
What you saying?
What bear have you seen playing with a ball? What kind of bear are you talking about, Mike? He plays with balls. Tell me one way your husband reminds you of a bear.
He's brown.
Oh.
It's up there.
She's brown. Name something a cat might do during a dinner party that's an appetite killer.
Crap on the table.
Crap on the table. Jenny, the boss might say he's a lion in the boardroom, but he's a blank in the bedroom.
What about a monkey? It's up there.
Yeah. What? I mean, when you say monkey, what would make you pick monkey?
He's everywhere.
Oh, watch out, Miss Jenny.
There you go.
Monkey! He may be a lion in the boardroom, but he's a blank in the bedroom.
Turtle, Steve.
You better be glad. You sure better be glad. You sure better be glad you're going to sudden death. Because that answer right there, your ass was going home. A turtle.
It's up there, Steve.
No, it's not. It ain't even, the audience don't even think it's up there. How many of y'all think turtle is up there? Stop it. Stop it. You're being nice, and you don't have to. Now, the rest of your family, they clapping. They know good and hell. You know good and hell well turtle ain't up there. It's not up there. Turtle! Tell me a place that dead people hang out.
They hang out around their families, haunting them. That's haunting them.
Hey, who is that? Who is that over there laying on the couch? Oh, that's Uncle Willie. I've never met him. Well, he's been dead 2 years. We just keep him over there. Hang around their family. Name a question Grandma asked a 90-year-old man on a date that starts with, are you what?
Are you impotent?
Are you impotent? You realize it'll be a short evening when your date meets you carrying a what?
A weapon.
A weapon. Make an animal sound that turns a farmer on.
Bah. Bah.
What the hell? I'm going to let y'all write your own joke on that one. Because that sucker was bah. 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 Family can still talk to 100 married men. What would you do if your wife insisted you get a vasectomy?
Get a second opinion.
Wait a minute. Second opinion from who? It's your wife, dog.
From the surgeon.
From the surgeon.
Yeah.
Yeah. He gonna get a second opinion. After his wife told him to get one, he gonna go check with some other people. Second opinion. Oh, wow. Oh my God. Oh my God, great answer. Name an appliance that describes your moves in the bedroom.
Toaster.
Toaster. Big John.
Washing machine.
Washing machine. Because
I gyrate.
A washing machine cause you what?
I gyrate.
All right.
Yeah.
I got to go down there and see what church you go to. If a man calls his wife's bottom good and plenty, what candy does she call his package?
Peanuts.
A Tootsie Roll.
Blow Pop.
Big Mouth.
Michael, name something that a woman who's naughty might leave out for Santa.
Sex toys.
Name something you hope doesn't fall apart while you're on it.
My wife.
Gene, name something that has to be licked. All right.
A woman.
At what age do a lot of men look like they should be wearing a bra?
15.
Oh, name a famous Harry.
I think there's a Harry on the Three Stooges.
If they made a movie called Bad Grandma, what might you see Grandma do?
Prostituting.
Hey, if someone pulls into a parking spot you were waiting for, what would you be tempted to do?
Flatten their tires.
Flatten their tires.
Yes, and then I pray about it.
You'll flatten their tires, then pray about it.
Yes, I would.
Yeah. I'd like to run into my ex-boyfriend with a what?
Car.
Name something you'd do to a guy who dumped you on your birthday.
I would bust the windows out his car.
If someone pulls into a parking spot you were waiting for, what would you be tempted to do?
I would be tempted to key their car, see? Yeah.
I would do like Jasmine Sullivan and bust the windows out their car.
Hit them.
Physically hit them.
And I'd like to run into my ex-boyfriend with a what?
A hammer?
Name a household object that gets thrown during a fight.
A knife.
Name something that starts with an F that makes you happy.
Fingers?
Cameron, yes, when sir. A man's wife is out of town, name something of hers he might sleep with.
I don't want this to go the wrong way, but I'm gonna say one of her friends.
Name something you might have to jiggle to get it working.
We're gonna say a man's private parts.
Name something bad about a guy that doesn't show up in a photo.
He has very small private parts.
Name something you might take with you when you go to the bathroom.
A plunger.
Name something of your wife's you use when she's not looking.
Her panties.
Name something you might be willing to fake your own death to get out of.
Jury duty.
If a man is a good liar, he'd make a great what?
Husband.
Husband. If your ex-husband were reincarnated, which animal would he come back as?
A roach.
Breaking news, Santa left Mrs. Claus. Ran off with a what?
All the children.
Name something a male dog might do in front of a female dog to impress her.
Hump on her?
Poof.
I'm gonna say their butt crack.
Their man junk. Their hairy butt.
KY jelly?
Farts. Snot!
A bastard.
Pee. Spit.
Sex toy.
A hairball.
How about a sex magazine?
Folks.
What do we do?
I'm gonna have to say that they go and get hair transplants.
They go get what?
I didn't want to say it to you, but they get like hair transplants because they're going bald.
Well, I'm not going to get one because
you,
I'm just
no,
fine.
But you look
you stop
like
talking
that.
To me about it. Now. I'm not going to get one.
No, but this fits you.
Stop talking to me. Not going to get some plugs put in my hair. Midlife crisis, they go and put, I don't want to say it to you because you could use a bunch of them. Yours would cost millions to do because you don't have a lick of hair. You so rubbish. Midlife crisis, go get your hair done. Part of a fish you wouldn't want to find in your fish taco.
The part he uses to go to the bathroom with.
Right. Good answer.
The butt.
Fish butt.
Yes, good answer, Benaiah. Good answer, Benaiah.
I've been fishing probably gotta be at least 50 years I've been fishing. I done cut up a lot of fish. Ain't never had to take butt off. Fish butt! If dogs use computers, what would they post pictures of on the internet? Terrell.
The girlfriend cat, a cat.
The girlfriend cat. That's amazing how you thought of that. I can't respond to it because such a different answer. I've seen Stranger Things. The girlfriend cat. Name the first woman who might be inducted into the Booty Hall of Fame.
Michelle Obama.
Well, you can't put Michelle Obama in no damn hall, Booty Hall of Fame.
Yes. Oh,
this
yes.
woman got 4 degrees. She been the first lady.
And a good booty.
She got 4 degrees and a good booty.
Shut up! Can't put Michelle Obama in that. We're not gonna drag Michelle Obama name into this ignorant ass survey.
What? She's up there.
No, she ain't up there.
Yes, yes.
No, she's not. Michelle Obama.
Oh.
All right, there, Mr. Potato Head plays strip poker. What's the first thing to go?
His big lips.
Miss Deb, it started with the way you looked at me. Then, after you gave your answer, you did this. You know, like if you pull yours in, it might soften the blow for me. I've been attacked my entire life about my facial features. I have been Mr. Potato Head damn near my whole life. But then she gonna lean in the mic. His big lips. Thank you, Miss Deb. Your big lips. Some men are chick magnets. What might make a man a chick repellent?
Bad personality.
He got a bad personality. Number 7. Number 6.
Bad hair.
What the hell? You got what? Hey, hey. Really? You got a problem with cigar? Now I'm bald head? Why don't we just put big lips on that? Number 4, big ass lips. Say it. So I swear to God, say it. Ha ha! I'm back. Name a reason you'd like to see Steve Harvey perform at Chippendales. And then the slow ass response.
Yeah. I thought there was more to the question.
Oh, yes.
Your package.
I don't care if it ain't up there. Good answer. Good answer. Number 1.
Sorry.
I take my clothes off, start dancing at Chippendales. You know how many fans I'm gonna lose. Kathy, we asked 100 women, name a reason you like to see Steve Harvey perform at Chippendales.
How you rip your clothes off.
You just want me to rip my clothes
That's
off.
That's right.
You better watch yourself. You better go on, girl. You've been just sitting up watching Family Feud talking about, I want to just rip his clothes off. Tear my clothes off, Miss Kathy. All right, talk to 100 women. Name a reason you'd like to see Steve Harvey perform at Chippendales.
So I can get a lap dance from you.
The little nursing girl want a lap dance. Okay, here we go. A kid might say, I saw, I'm reading the question. Man, I got a headache messing with these two families right here. On the roll, if your dog ran away, name something you'd be surprised he took with him.
Is blanket the same as clothes?
I don't know.
Okay, blanket.
Well, I'm just the host, lady. I'm just the host. The hell if I know. I feel if you wrap him in it, I don't know if you got it wrapped around him. I don't know how you do your dog.
But if he's invisible, it's okay.
If he's invisible, I do the jokes, lady. I do the jokes. Would you mind women name something your husband has that would hurt his feelings if you made fun of it?
Bald head.
Hey. Why are you laughing at? That hard. I can't breathe. Ball head.
I love you, Steve.
Woo. Name something a bald man might object to someone doing to his head. Tyra.
Shaving it.
Shaving it.
Rubbing it.
Hate it. Rubbing it.
Yeah!
Hey. All right, Miss Cynthia, name something a bald man might object somebody doing to his head.
Hitting it in the back.
Mm. Oh, yeah. She's done it before. She's done that before.
You did that a million times?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. I'm experienced.
You know, man, my wife do that to me, too.
Yeah. You know,
like, if I, especially if I'm doing something, I'm on the phone, yes. I'm talking to somebody, and the conversation got a little crazy, she'll walk in and just slap me in the back of the head. And I spin real fast because I think it's one of the kids playing. And then it's her, and I got, can't say nothing. Hit him in the back of the head. Bernard, only one strike. Name something a bald man might object to somebody doing to his head.
Patting it.
Patting it. I hate that. Yeah. Patting it. Before a man goes to prison, what might he do to make himself really unattractive?
Shave his head.
Shave his head. What that got to do with it? Jonna, okay, when you're nude, name something that feels good on your body.
A breeze.
The breeze. Yeah. Like...
That's right.
Yes. Thank you. Yes. Yeah. In those dark places. Yeah. Just a breeze. Ooh. Feel like you got a York peppermint patty.
Okay.
After you murder someone, name something specific you must quickly get rid of.
The body.
The body.
The weapon that you use.
The weapon that you use. Pass the plate. Deja, after you murder someone, name something specific you must quickly get rid of.
You gotta clean up all the blood, Steve.
Clean up the blood. Cameron, after you murder someone, name something specific you gotta quickly get rid of.
The bullet shells.
The shells. You got to pick up them shells.
Oh, man.
Devon, after you murder someone, name something specific you must quickly get rid of.
I'm going to say the fingerprints, Steve.
The fingerprints.
Good job, baby. Good job. Good job.
Mabora, after you murder someone, name something specific you must quickly get rid of.
Steve, you're going to have to get rid of the witnesses.
Yeah. This family over here got some good answers. I'm going, damn. Picking up shells, getting rid of witnesses, wiping down prints. Somebody over here been to court. I ain't saying nobody did nothing, but somebody over here been sitting up through some proceedings. Because this right here, she done got rid of all the damn witnesses. Derek, one answer left. You can clear the board, but you got two strikes. You got to be careful this time. John, family can steal.
The shovel that I buried him with.
That's right, Papa.
Yeah. If this ain't my family over here, I grew up with all this right here. The shovel. Oh! I named one of my sons Ali.
Awesome. Good name.
Yeah. My third son, his middle name is Ali.
Is he ruggedly handsome and brilliant too?
You better know it.
Yeah.
Look just like his daddy. Oh! Rock, give me a reason the divorced man might not recognize his ex.
Well, Steve, he probably went blind.
Let's go, Steve. Yes.
Rock, you're saying that he probably went blind?
Can't recognize if you can't see it.
Good answer, Rock. I still can't play with that.
Yeah, you support that answer?
I support my man. That's my man. Good answer. You get
He went blind. Yeah.
How you like that, Steve?
Oh, that's one of the things I hate about this game. Oh, that's one of them right there. That you can give a completely stupid answer and actually discover that there's two more stupid people in the world. Instead of the fireplace, name something y'all be surprised to see Santa come out of.
Toys R Us.
You know, Rock, the object of this game, I know since you got that last answer, he blind. So I figure you just, all your answers are just gonna be the one two people says. Now you just said Toys R Us.
I'm up there.
If that answer is up there.
Come on.
Hey man, let me tell you something. I'm gonna lean over, I'm gonna let you slap me. Toys R Us! Name a part of your body you'd have a hard time touching your nose with.
Okay, I'm gonna go with your lips. Right? It's up there. It's up there.
That's good, Andy.
Try it.
Girl, I done damn near smothered myself before. You see these lips right here? You don't think I touch me? You gotta be out your damn mind. I cover my nose, your nose. We'll both be struggling to breathe. I done kissed a girl and we done both damn near died. Your lips. All right, Cam, we got two strikes now. You gotta be careful. The Demarest family can steal. Name something that's romantic to a woman but sappy to a man.
A long greeting card. You know those romantic poems, greeting cards?
Okay. A long...
Go
A long green card, you know, the ones with the long, like, line, they got some lines on it, and then they have another line on it, and then right there, and you think you're through reading, but then you open it up, and it's some more on another page. One of them long gift cards, just like your answer. A long green card. Mr. Abraham, I know it's been a while, but let's think. Name something a man ask a woman that starts with, what's your...
Your eye color. I don't know.
What is your eye color? Fellas, this is what happens when you've been married for a while. Your mind goes.
Go, dude.
You can't think no more. Excuse me.
Right.
What's your eye color?
Yeah. All right.
Now, unless you on a blind date and your ass is blind, that question might hardly ever come up.
Like this.
What's your eye color? Can you ask me a question?
A clarifying question.
A clarifying question. Hey, man, look here. Yeah. All that judge and litigation stuff, we don't do this a game show. We don't do arbitration in the middle of the damn game. Okay, go ahead. What's the question?
They told me, they said deodorant. Is perfume and deodorant the same thing or different thing?
They're different things.
I go now. We're going to say perfume.
Perfume! Ray Vaughn, give me something you'd hate for somebody to do right in your face.
Urinate.
Urinate.
Yes.
Wow.
I would not like that. Yeah. I don't like that.
No. You don't like that.
Not at all. No.
Not at all.
The thought of it alone makes me feel bad.
That's right. You don't like that at all.
No. No.
But you know for sure you don't like that.
I'm positive.
Yeah.
That I haven't tried it. Positive.
I didn't ask you, did you try it? You know, I'm just saying, you know, maybe you wasn't trying to try it. Just, you know. Urinate! Oh. Name an appliance that describes your moves in the bedroom.
How about a dryer?
Good answer! Good answer,
I'm so hot.
I don't want
to
hear this.
Oh, you so hot.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
Little girls didn't want to hear that.
No.
Your daddy just hot. Just out there, just, you know, just letting them have it. Come on in here and get yourself dried off.
There you go.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Come on in here, girl. Oh. Yeah. Y'all daddy sexy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That
boy right there. Boy in there just in there just tumbling. A dryer, put it on tumble. Let's go. A dryer.
Oh.
Pamela, name something thrill seekers love to ride on.
Hot air balloon. I know.
Ooh, this fast.
It's high.
Girl, I ain't been this fast in my life.
Yeah.
This hot air balloon about to blow my wig off.
Yeah, but Steve,
that
when the balloon burst.
Be quiet, Pamela. Hot air balloon. Joe.
Yes, sir.
You have no idea the money you're going to be spending on a wife, man.
I got a plan, though, Steve.
Oh, I love this right here. He ain't been married for 2 months. He got a plan. Y'all probably want to hear it, don't you? I know I damn sure do. Tell me, Joe, what's the plan?
Never mind, Steve. Forget I said anything.
That's right. Thank you, Joe. That's right. Good job. Smart guy. Seriously, smart guy. Yeah. Big hand for Joe, folks.
Right, Joe.
Hey, Dennis, the magician just pulled the coin out of my what?
Your butt.
Come on, man. Yeah. Dennis.
I knew that would be
come on, man. Let's just go and get this out the way. Why are we messing around? I never give a damn about your ear. Look at the guy. Stop. Pop. That's what I'm waiting on. When I read it up there. I don't know when they gonna say ass. She said pants. I went close. But. Yeah. You the mama down here just got you up on the auction block right now.
Yeah.
They ain't looking at you. Well, what you think, Devon?
I think she's trying to push this grandkid situation a little early on me. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But I'm trying to live my life a little bit, you know?
Yeah, you should, man.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, live it to the fullest. Get it all out your system.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. How long you think it'd be, Devon, before you get it all out your system? You're 23 now. Because it ain't out your system.
No. I'm thinking I'm at least start thinking around 27, 28, you know?
Yeah, that's once, a good time. Know, yeah, that's good, man.
I think while I still got all my hair, I'm going to do the best I can. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Now Devon.
Yes, sir.
What the hell did you mean by all your hair? You know, like, so what you're saying is when you ain't got no more hair, it's over?
Nah.
That what it sound like you said to me, Devon.
I just think the game changes a little bit.
Yeah, it changes.
Changes
a
just a little bit.
Are you losing it?
I am. I think so. Yeah, you see my dad down there.
Yeah.
You know.
But I make you look good.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, you make it look good.
I make it look good.
Oh, yeah, I see that. Little Jane, two strikes, got to be careful. It's bad when you got ants in your pants. It'd be worse if you had what bug in your pants?
Fleas.
Fleas?
Good answer.
I don't know if y'all starting to catch on here, but we have two very country families here. Because flea is one syllable. Fleas. When you see people taking one syllable word and turning it into two, they from the country. Fleas. What the circus closed? What act had the hardest time finding another job?
The sword swallower.
The sword swallower. Nice job. Now, Derek.
Yes, sir.
As a footnote,
just okay.
So you'll know that is that word is actually sword.
That's what I said. Sword.
Yeah, y'all heard what he said. Y'all know good and hell well what he said. That he gonna try to change. That's what I said.
That's what I said.
I know what you thought you said.
Sword swallow. I say it again.
Say it again.
Sword. Swallow.
Good answer.
Yeah. Sword swallow. Loud and wrong. Just loud and wrong. Come on, Cameron, don't let me down. Make an animal sound that turns a farmer on.
Pecaw.
That's a chicken, Steve.
I know what it is. Do it again. Yeah. See, you ain't from the country, are you?
No.
So you got to put it in your
tongue.
No. See, you got to go. Yeah, that's how you gotta do it. Chicken. Devon, make an animal sound that turns a farmer on.
I'm gonna go ahead and go with Rooster Steve.
Yeah, that's a rooster. Yo, let me hear it one more time. This is the sickest, angriest rooster.
Getting up too early, man.
One more time. But you see how he looking though.
Gotta sell
it. Sir Rooster. Hey, Kim, name something a Steve Harvey doll might have more of than a Barbie doll.
Whiter teeth.
Whiter teeth. Yeah. She said teeth. She said teeth. You ain't have to throw lips in there. She said teeth. I know I got more lips than Barbie got. Name something a Steve Harvey doll might have more of than a Barbie doll, other than them big ass lips of his.
Steve, I'm gonna go with color. Yeah.
More color, bam!
Yeah.
Girl,
yeah.
It seems there is never a good time to ask for what?
Anything. Anything, Steve. Anything. Up there.
I ain't got it.
Yeah, anything.
Go ahead, ask me.
Don't ask me
for a damn thing. Like,
I ain't got it.
Anything. Name something you'd love just once to see Steve Harvey wearing.
A wig.
A wig. Name something you'd love just once to see Steve Harvey wearing.
Nothing at all.
It's not me, it's 100 women. It's not me.
Nothing at all. Oh. How the hell don't nobody want to see me naked? You know how damn demoralizing this question is right now. Name something a woman licks when she's trying to be sexy.
I'm gonna say them.
Huh?
You might lick them. The person, you might lick the guy.
What relation are you to her?
That's my aunt.
And this one here?
My cousin.
This one?
My cousin. My aunt.
Okay. So your aunts and cousins, see the
my
answer they
here
gave?
Too.
And your grandmama here. Mm-hmm. That's what you won't say in front of your grandma.
I'm just
you won't say that in front of your grandmama.
I didn't say I would, but you surveyed
well, who you,
people.
You just gave the answer. Look, ain't
you
nobody
heard,
next.
You heard,
ain't
though.
Nobody next.
You said 100 people. I don't know who kind of 100 people you just asked.
I ain't said nothing about no 100 people. All I said was top five answers on the board. When did you hear me say 100 people? Don't be trying to drag everybody else into your little nasty answer. This is your answer, Ashley. You go on this answer
right.
In front of your grandmama.
I'm sorry, Granny.
Now, with your little fast self up here, licking on people. Licking on them. Name a talk show host who's your best friend in your head.
Oprah.
Oprah.
Steve Harvey.
Steve Harvey.
Man. Who answered me?
This is my show. I can't beat Oprah doing a damn thing. Five Stone, talk to 100 married men. Name a reason you're afraid your wife's actually turning into a witch.
She
now
got,
hold on, Five Stone. You're married to
Angie.
Angie.
Correct.
Be very careful.
I know. Oh, I know.
Fausto, I've seen her flip a switch.
Oh, yeah.
And brother, you need to be careful. Matter of fact, just think about it. You only got one strike. Here, just take a strike. This game ain't worth the hell that could be waiting on you down there. That yellow down there don't exactly represent sunshine. You see yellow every day, and it usually means caution. Be very careful, Fausto. Be very careful, my brother. We asked 100 men, married men, name a reason you're afraid your wife is actually turning into a witch.
She gets a black cat as a pet.
That's a nice, man. Yeah, that's how you answer that. That's what you do. Sometimes you just got to take an ex. It ain't worth it. You know, that's, you know what I'm saying? She got a black cat. Name a reason it would be great to have Steve Harvey as your father.
He's rich.
Yes, yes. Girl, you better... You better jump on your buzzer. He rich. Brittany, give me a reason it'd be great to have Steve Harvey as your father.
He's handsome.
Good answer.
Yeah, damn shame that ain't gonna be up there. He handsome. It ain't gonna be up there. I'm good. Don't you ain't gotta feel bad for me. I'm comfortable with it. I've known this for years. If all the TV hosts got into a fist fight, who'd win?
Steve Harvey.
You better understand.
You better know it.
Let me tell you something. I don't know what the answer is up there, but can't nail one of them whoop me.
And I know this.
I'm hood ready.
And you got backup, because I'll knock a sucker out.
You heard that.
Yeah.
You got, that's why you can't.
Yeah.
Number one. Come on, let's go. Currently a carpenter, street organizer and everything. Now, let me ask you this. When was you in the Temptations? That's what I mean. Boy, if you ain't my cousin. Oh. Ricky. Boy, let me tell you something, man. If you was a little bit bigger, see, that's you about a 44?
46.
46?
Yes, sir. Think about it.
I got a little something. Think about it. I got a little something in there. Try it on, man. Boy, I'm getting nervous. Come on, man, please, please, oh, please. Thank you, man. Man, thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you, man. Oh, man, how I look. All right, let's go. We asked 100 married women, tell me a reason your husband probably wouldn't get much work as a fashion model.
Now, Steve, remember to making me say that, but okay. Because he's bald.
He's bald. Because he's bald. The hell that got to do with it? First of all, you say I ain't photogenic. I told you I wasn't attractive. He a fat cow. I'm working on it. Now I'm bald here. I just can't be no damn model. No, it's cool. I laugh at stuff like that. I got a sense of humor. Don't worry about it. On the commercial break, I got something for him. Name a reason a woman smart. Might say my date last smart. Night reminded me of Steve Harvey.
Money smile.
Steve, we're going to say smile.
I smile. Number seven.
Oh, no. No.
I like that one right there. Number six.
Loud and chatty.
I'm the host of the show. What the hell am I supposed to do? Number three. That was a store that sold husbands. Most people try to buy one that came with a good what?
Sorry, Mom, but package.
They're saying that that's the same thing as body. Okay. Me and you know it ain't. But... Oh, you can have a good body. Hey, you ain't got to have a good body, though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I ain't all that right here. Oh, Lord, Jesus. Woo! Woo! Sometimes I get out the shower, I just stay in there 10, that's 15 right. minutes. I can't believe I say some of the stuff I say. Name something the man of your dream has, your husband sadly does not.
Hair, Steve.
Come on, come on.
You know,
my husband got hair.
You can have, you know, the man of your dreams cannot have hair.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really care who in your family got hair.
Hair!
When a husband and wife have an argument, what usually happens at the end of the argument?
The husband says, I'm sorry.
Yes, yes, yes! Yes!
24 years, 24
always.
Years.
Always. You right. just say, I'm sorry.
Me.
She can be dead wrong. You have to say, you're sorry. All right, Dawson, name something that can be soft or hard. Store that sold husbands, most people would try to buy one that came with a good what?
Good head of hair.
A good head of hair. Hair don't make a man. When you get to heaven, what do you hope every man you meet has?
Hair.
Hair.
Sorry, Steve. Nothing personal.
Turn around. So you think, because you done drew all this in your head, you think you're going to heaven because of your hairstyle? Hair! What's your worst physical flaw?
Don't take offense, but lack of hair.
Lack of hair.
Yeah.
Good answer.
Lack of hair.
Name something you see on a man's face that would make you not want to kiss him.
Well, if he was Steve Harvey, maybe not, but a mustache.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Well, any smart woman would want to kiss you, but, you know.
I just tell Toledo.
In general, a mustache.
Well, you know, need to try it sometime. Don't knock it. You never know. Don't want to kiss him. He's got a mustache on his face. 200 men, name something of yours you wouldn't want to shrink.
Nothing personal, but I say hairline.
Hairline.
Yeah.
All right, man, tell me one good thing about being bald.
You look sexy.
Whatever.
We look sexy, and we don't even care if it ain't up there now. Look sexy.
Sexy like Steve.
One little player. Everybody over here. Yeah. Yeah. All the bald head men in the building. Yeah. Get your sexy on, baby. Yeah. And you can do a lot of other things too with it at night.
Yes, sir.
Come on, you're being brutally honest. Name a reason she might give a guy for not dating.
Now, I swear, I would not say that.
Yes, you would.
No, I wouldn't.
Oh, you wouldn't say
I wouldn't, that? But I think some girls might not because he's bald.
Because he's bald.
Yeah. But no, I would not say that.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. You're not going to touch me after you said that one.
I swear. Oh, not me.
I would never date you because of you, Mr. Baldy. Yes! Name something you'd like to do to Steve Harvey's head. This is not good.
Slap it!
Slap it.
Slap it.
All I try to do for women, and you down to drop kicking my head. Got your little funny one off. You got two strikes, you gotta be careful. Hey, church lady, you don't want to do that. I'll tell you right now, church lady, gonna have yourself in a real situation. Praise the Lord. Yeah, you're gonna have to call him in the midnight hour. If you... Sit on it. Name an object that's the size of Steve Harvey's head. Yeah, Tom.
A watermelon?
Watermelon.
It's all about the car, Steve.
Renee?
A bowling ball?
Shut up, Tom. Bowling ball! That's the
point. We're gonna play, Steve.
I'm an object that's the size of Steve Harvey's head. This sucks.
Well, a helmet.
A helmet. To go on top of somebody's head. I ought to bust you in your mouth. Damn head ain't big as no damn helmet. I hope it ain't up there. A helmet! Name an object that's the size of Steve Harvey's head.
A hiney cheek. One hiney cheek.
A hiney cheek. One hiney cheek.
That's my mouth.
My head look like the half of somebody else. My head look like half just somebody ass.
Please be there.
Better not be there. I'll tear this if it's up there, I'll tear this damn board down. Steve Harvey's head look like half of somebody's ass. Give me a term of affection people use for their mates. Come on.
Husband.
I hear you, Miss Mary. I'm ready to hell. I'm going to say something. Husband. You had a tail. Name a place you go where it would be wagging.
if I was a dog.
We talking about the beach.
But I would go to the beach.
But listen to
if
me.
A dog go to the beach, he's gonna be happy.
But Alan, listen to me. But Alan, listen to me. What? Nobody said a damn thing about you being a damn dog.
But that's where I'm going.
Yeah, okay.
But, well, we're gonna I'm thinking like a dog. Because yeah, I gotta tell
you. No, we ain't it ain't said nothing about no damn dog. Because that ain't had to go be in there. So you're a nurse?
I am a nurse. I'm a nurse. My husband owns a funeral home. I met him at
a
funeral.
Oh, well, ain't this? Yeah. Bet the death rate at that hospital been skyrocketing. Oh, all her lunch break, she go get her cell phone.
I think you need to get up here. I'm just saying. Room 206, it ain't looking good.
You mean you a nurse and your husband own a funeral home, a very successful funeral home?
He owns two funeral homes.
Hell yes. About to get a third.
Well, I'm so happy you found a man of your dreams.
Yes.
Miss Debbie, talk to 100 married people. Something you've caught your spouse doing in the middle of sex.
Well, maybe somebody else's. I'm not like it. I'm sorry.
Okay.
No, I'm sorry.
Let's do it, baby. Well, let's meet everybody, Michael.
Thank you. Okay. Well, I have here my very versatile brother, Vernon. My my cousin, Ika.
Vernon?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You all right?
Yes, sir. Yes. I'm just excited to be here.
Excited?
A little excited.
Excited or scared?
It's a thin line,
this my brother, Vernon.
I want to make sure.
Vernon, everything okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, looked a little startled when he said your name to you.
I wasn't ready. I wasn't.
I know. Vernon had that look like he had warrants. Ricky, one answer left. Two strikes, free and family can steal. 24 hours to live. What's on your to-do list?
I'm going to experiment with drugs.
Derek, name something you think of when you hear the word grind.
Grinding it out, baby. Yeah. That's right.
Grinding it out.
Keelan, the ladies' man who thinks he's smooth as silk. Kendra, the beauty queen of the family, but also thinks she's Miss Martha Stewart.
I got it. Your daddy lost his mind. Introduce everybody, Vanessa.
Okay, Steve, this is my uncle, AKA the Reverend Gary Dehart. This is my beautiful sister, older sister. We got Usher Jr., the college graduate, Demetrius Trayvon Jr., and the lovely social worker out of the family, Natalie Greer.
Devon.
Yes.
What?
Oh, don't try to be silent now.
Who is this? Devon.
Yes, Steve.
That's what I'm talking about. Wait a minute. There ain't nobody signed up for you.
Steve.
What's wrong? What you think it is?
I think they're intimidated. I really think they're intimidated. Because I'm very strong and independent,
mm-hmm.
Outgoing.
See, let's stop right here. Let's just stop this. I think it's the outgoing. I think it's a lot for you to just
keep coming out and then just keep going. Devon.
Yes, Dad.
That's what I'm talking about.
Right.
All right, if you woke up doing surgery, which I believe you would, what would you hate to see the surgeon hold?
A beer. We securing it.
I'm afraid of her. She turned around. We passed it down and put my eye out. You know what? You crazy, but your ass can play.
I walk you every day, honey. 3 times a day. I get off work at 4:15. I get home by 5:45. My dinner cooked by 7. I watch you from 7:30 to 10. So I missed the half for the first 7 o'clock, but I watch it from 7:30 to 10.
That's right. That's why she good. So if you want to get good, you got to start watching.
Yeah.
3 hours every day, 7 to 10. Don't miss it. Gary, listen to me, man. Here's the deal. If it's there, you're still alive, but this time you got 2 strikes. If it's not there, the other team can steal and win. Gary, tell me something, Drek. Stop clapping, Gary. Clapping. You ain't even gave your. I can't even read this damn card.
Excited, Steve. I'm ready. I'm ready.
You clap after you give the answer. And they told you that in rehearsal. Clap and say good answer after you give the answer.
So we have Leah, she's the oldest, and we have April, and then we have Noelle. She wants to roll you up and smoke you. She loves you, Steve.
Roll who up?
Roll you up.
Esther?
Yes, hi.
Aww. This is the nicest family.
We love you.
I'm so damn scared right now. Normally I walk up to people, I'm just as friendly, but I'm so damn scared right now. She just wanted to shake hands, that's all it was, but I'm scared because of her. It's her sister who rolled me up and smoked me. What the
that's
hell
why she
is
needs those
that?
Matches, Steve.
Huh?
That's why she needs those matches.
Yeah, oh, that's what you need the matches for.
Yes, of course. You gotta make it hot, baby.
Just say one. I'm dying.
Oh, Jesus. Esther? How you doing?
How you doing? I'm just staring at your beautiful teeth, you know.
That's her business.
Yeah.
I just went to the dentist about a month ago.
I could tell. Yeah, you're doing good.
Okay.
Y'all floss a lot.
Good. You know what we want to hear.
Huh?
Yeah, you know what we want to hear. That's what I want to hear.
What, you want to hear what?
That you floss a lot.
Oh, that I own.
Yeah.
She's pure. She's pure.
You know what I want to hear? What? I'm so damn scared. Oh, Lord have mercy. Name a souvenir that a woman might bring home from a male strip show.
Can I say some handcuffs?
Okay. Can I say some handcuffs? Yeah, if you want to. Handcuffs! Name something a man might lose that would make him less attractive. Yeah, with the other
hair. Not on you, but the hair.
The hair? The hair. You gonna play? All right. She used the other hand.
That's her power hand.
And still hit it.
All right,
Noel. All right. Noel?
Yes, Steve.
This ain't gonna go good. Name something a man might lose that would make him less attractive.
That's Skrilla. Money.
Skrilla.
Cheddar.
Money.
What do you do, man?
I'm an account executive for ASC Direct. We're a service disabled veteran owned small business. And I don't know if they told you, but I'm also business-licious. See, let me explain it to you, Steve.
Stop right there.
You know, stop, okay.
And then come talking about, I'm delicious. Now, see, what you ain't finna do, big fella, is look me in my eye and have the word delicious come out your damn mouth. Now, cause you're not, you might be delicious to her, but you don't be damn thing to me. And I'm gonna need you to fix this right now. We looking at each other. He talking about, I don't know if they told you or not. Damn, but I'm delicious.
I gotta explain, Steve.
Well, big boy, I let me out news for you. You ain't delicious to me. Go ahead, explain.
Let me explain, Steve.
Okay,
I got the business persona in the front. See this? That's business. But when you turn around, I'm delicious.
It's working, ain't it? It's working. It's working. Yeah.
You know what?
What's that?
I think I see it. Name a word or phrase that starts with hip.
I'm hoping this is right, Steve.
Hip.
You got the hip ups. How long you done had the hip up? You want me to scare you or something? You the first person I ever met had the hip up. If that's up there, I'ma shoot myself in the teeth on national TV. And I'm gonna send the tape to TMZ. JT, name something that starts with the word ding.
Well, Steve, I'm gonna go with ding around the rosy.
Come on, man. We asked 100 women, name a way you like your desserts and your men.
Strawberry.
Vanessa! Woo! Yeah!
Ready? Ready? Here we go. Strawberry! He'll ever get one. Cause something wrong with Kenny. Kenny crazy. Name something women wear that was obviously designed by men because it's uncomfortable but sexy.
Mm. Texas, Steve. Texas.
Good answer.
Texas. It's up there. Right there.
Yeah. I'm good up there. Just tell me what you said.
Texas, Steve. Yeah, Texas.
I mean, what?
You heard of the state?
The state of Texas.
Yeah.
T-E-X-A-S?
Mm-hmm. That's a good answer, Steve. Watch it. I'll teach you. Yes.
You're from Tennessee.
Yeah. Texas.
Boy, you crazy.
Fill in the blank.
Never ever have I what?
Slept with an elephant.
Besides chicken, name a bird people eat.
Venison.
Name something that ends with the word pit.
Pit bull.
And what would you be shocked come home and see your wife wearing?
Another man, Steve.
Name something in your bedroom that would be weird if it glowed in the dark.
My genitalia.
Name something you'd hate to fall off of you in the middle of a hot date.
Come on, Kevin, come on.
A chair.
Name something that follows the word spare. Frank.
Breakfast.
Spare breakfast. That's the extra one. That's the one sitting over there on the table. Ain't nobody touching. Get spare breakfast. Besides a bull, name an animal that has bull in its name.
Angel bull.
What?
Angel bull.
A bull angel.
Yeah.
The hell are you talking about? Angel bull. Anybody. Anybody. Anybody.
And that was a good answer.
No, it ain't. Anybody. Anybody. Shut up. It's not up there. Name something a man finds in the house that makes him suspect his wife might kill him. Brittany.
Another woman's panties.
Steel. An animal a farmer's wife says the farmer acts like in the bedroom.
Spaghetti. Spaghetti.
Name something a man quickly hides under the bed when his wife enters the bedroom.
The fact that he's naked.
Name a word that rhymes with fudge.
Mud.
Victor.
Mud.
Mud. Brenda, name something some people buy and some people make at home.
Bruce Springsteen. I don't know.
Julie, give me a B word that describes your bottom.
Rump. Ooh. Huh? Rump.
A B word.
Oh, a B word.
Name something dogs do to people that people wouldn't do to dogs.
Eat with them.
Huh?
Eat with them.
Name a reason the tooth fairy might not leave a kid any money for his tooth.
The kid was away at camp.
Huh?
The kid was at camp?
That has no chance of being up here.
Oh.
Name something an employee might do if they think they're being underpaid.
Work harder. Work harder.
Work harder.
Work harder.
Work harder. Yeah, gotta prove yourself, yeah. You gotta prove you deserve it. You gotta deserve it.
You're not paying me. And I'm finna work harder.
Either that or I'm gonna go back to school.
Go back to school. Work harder, improve yourself, go back to school. Keisha, name something that might be running down your leg.
Your underwear?
Some mugger would hate to discover about you when he tried to mug you.
You smell bad.
Name something you'd see grandma wearing that tells you she's looking for a new man.
An apron.
Name something you'd hate to discover was living in your attic. You said, big old bad monster.
You would.
Survey said she said you would. Survey said, 100 married women. When you have a fight with your husband, what percentage at a time is he wrong? You said 100%. Survey said. Yeah. Name a bird that makes a lot of noise. You said. Hummingbird. Survey said. When you have a fight with your husband, what percentage of the time is he wrong?
100%.
Try again.
90%.
Name someone a bride would be mad at her groom kissed a little too long at their wedding.
Best man.
Yeah. The best man. Woo! Mars?
Yes, sir.
Name someone a bride would be mad that her groom kissed a little too long at their wedding.
Father. The father.
When you get to a party, what's the first thing you check out?
Jewelry.
Before a date, Name a food a flat-chested woman might stuff in her bra.
Apples.
Apples.
Onions.
Onions.
Dude.
Onions.
Sweet onions.
Listen, sweet onions.
Watermelon.
Good answer.
Watermelon.
Chicken.
What?
Chicken.
You know, chicken cutlets. Chicken cutlets. Yes. Chicken cutlets.
Chicken breasts.
Come on. Chicken cutlets.
That's what you went on. Y'all ain't want to run that number. Who you hollering at?
You got to stick him in there.
Chicken. Yeah, but you keep saying it like I don't know what you said. Chicken. Chicken cutlet. I heard you. Chicken. But who do that?
Right.
Just a damn raw-ass piece of chicken to stick it in their throat. Now you got big breasts, but your ass got salmonella. Chicken cutlets, chicken cutlets.
If a nurse were a magician, what might she pull out of a patient's bottle?
I would have to go with a light bulb. I've seen it.
You've seen that?
I think that's why I panicked when I said that.
You've actually seen that? Somebody has come into your space with a light bulb?
In the ER, yeah. People put a lot of weird stuff up their butt.
You know how drunk you got to be? Light bulb. Tomorrow, 100 married men. Name something you'd be alarmed to find in the trunk of your wife's car.
A dildo.
Dildo. Give me a word that rhymes with nanny.
Hanny.
What?
Hanny with an H.
Hanny. Hanny with an H.
Good answer.
Name something big you hope is in the small package someone gives you.
Wanger.
What?
Wanger. Penis. Wanger. What?
Wanger. Name something a big guy keeps in the folds of his belly.
A snack.
A snack. Talk to 100 married men. Name someone you'd hate to hear you hit on while you were drunk.
Your children.
Name something you do while on the couch that you also do in bed.
Rub yourself.
Tell me something that you put a deposit down. Okay, I gotta read this. He froze me. Your ass is gonna be on YouTube. Hey, Shaboy, name something one coworker might steal from another.
What about their desk or their cubicle, their office?
Just came in and stole the cubicle. My damn cubicle was right here. I bet that damn Savoy then came in here and stole my cubicle.
That's a good answer, Steve. Good answer.
Yeah, it is.
Cubicle. If your ex-husband, 100 divorced women, if your ex-husband were reincarnated, what animal would he come back as?
Let's say a scary cat.
A what?
Good answer.
A scary cat.
A cat. See, a cat.
Yeah. Oh, a cat. Yeah. Good answer.
Oh, a cat.
Good answer.
Good answer.
You're getting it. Good answer.
It's not a scary cat. Married man named something your wife might do if you made fun of her bottom.
Well, I'd go eat me some more cheesecake to enhance that bottom.
I tell you what I'm gonna do. You don't like what you're looking at? Mm. I'm gonna go make more ass. Eat some cheesecake and increase it. 100 women, tell me a country where you think the men are sexier than American men.
United States of America. America. What?
Wait, what was that question?
Yeah, repeat the question, Steve.
Edit that part out.
We asked 100 women, tell me a country where you think the men are sexier than American. United States of America. Oh, yeah. I see exactly where that answer came from. Well, go. You can't change it, but you want to go with that one?
Boy, the looks I got were unbelievable.
Yeah. You know, when your son doesn't go, good answer, Mom.
Yeah, that's bad.
Yeah,
that's
when
bad.
Most sons will support their mother no matter what.
No, not them. They,
you said that, you went, oh, wow. Said, your boy went, damn, Mama. United States of America. If Jane went on The Bachelorette, she might say to Tarzan, will you accept this what?
Education.
Good answer.
That's a great answer.
How many of y'all think that's up there? How many of y'all like me don't even think that's tied to the question at all? Sometimes I just check. Education ain't got a damn thing to do with The Bachelorette, Tarzan, or Jane, but let's see if it's up there. Education. Name something a rabbit might do in a magician's hat.
Fly away.
Yeah, good answer. Good answer.
Yes. Fly away.
Fly away.
Yeah.
Did you hear the question? Name something that a rabbit might do in the magician's hat. Anybody said nothing about name something that the dove might do in the magician's hat. The hell the rabbit gonna fly away? Wow. Y'all getting the huddling come up with. Here we go. Damn, roll, tide, roll. Here we go. Right there. I'm telling you, it's a lot of war eagles watching this laughing real hard right now. Telling you right now, if you think that rabbit gonna fly out that damn hat, do you know how rich that magician will be? You got a rabbit, y'all, that's about to fly out that. Just take off. I ain't doing these damn tricks no more. I'm fine. I'm getting out of here. I'm tired of this. Always wanted to be a bird any damn way. I'm out of here. The rabbit fly away out the hat. Name something that sports teams do to players that husbands wish they could do to their wives. Eddie.
Hit them. Like hit them, boom.
Good answer.
You know? Thinking football?
Hit them. Name a way you might be able to tell a man is married just by looking at him.
The way he talks.
The way he talks.
Oh,
they want to know what you mean by that.
What he's saying.
The way he talks.
The.
What he's saying. Be more specific.
He's running game. He's.
These producers are white.
Oh. Oops.
Yeah, whatever. Y'all can help her.
You just weed. You just weed.
He uses we a lot. Instead of saying I, he says we a lot. As he's talking about when we go places, when we...
Okay. We! Name an office supply you use to pick food out your teeth.
Paperweight.
Yeah. Yeah. But I don't get nothing else stuck in my damn mouth. Because I'm finna knock every last one of these. I'm sick of this meat all in the back of my teeth. I'm gonna put an end to this. Somebody give me that damn paperweight.
They got a gap.
Dentures,
a gap or denture.
Boy, shut up.
All right.
Paperweight. Name something of yours that's old and smells funny.
Some old friends.
Some old friends.
Name something you toss.
Toss them draws.
So toss them draws. Hey, if someone pulls into a parking spot you were waiting for, what would you be tempted to do?
Flatten their tires.
Flatten their tires.
Yes, and then I pray about it.
You'll flatten their tires, then pray about it.
Yes, I will.
Yeah. I'd like to run into my ex-boyfriend with a what?
Car.
Talked to 100 women. Name something you do to a guy who dumped you on your birthday.
I would bust the windows out his car.
If someone pulls into a parking spot you were waiting for, what would you be tempted to do?
I would be tempted to key their car, see? Yeah.
I would do like Jasmine Sullivan and bust the windows out their car.
Hit them.
Physically hit them. Yeah.
Physically hit them in your car. Yeah. We ask 100 single women, I'd like to run into my ex-boyfriend with a what?
A hammer.
Name something you might need two of if you're cheating on your spouse.
Two man parts.
Two man parts.
She gonna bob it on me. It's, you know.
Oh, she gonna rain a bob it on you. You gonna need that other one. Okay. Well, no, the Chris ain't cheating. There you go. Two man parts. When a husband and wife have an argument, what usually happens at the end of the argument?
The husband says, I'm sorry.
Yes, yes, yes.
24 years. 24
Always.
Years.
Always. You right. Just say I'm sorry.
Me.
She can be dead wrong. You have to say you're sorry. Name something that's long and wet. Victor. Pepe.
Maya.
Name something you wish your hubby would do just in the bathroom, not everywhere.
Men are often moving themselves around, adjusting themselves. In public, you see them walking down the street. They do.
Brian, name something a woman gets rid of when she wants to jumpstart a love life.
Vibrator.
Hey, when a woman isn't pretty, people always say she has a good what?
Real side.
Oh, I know exactly what you mean.
I know you do.
But you threw the judge into something.
A behind.
It, that's just two ways that way. It goes like this.
No,
then
you
go, fop.
Yeah.
And then it's a hook back. Fop. That's what they're looking for. A nice rear end. Now, if Santa went to a bar, who might be his wingman?
Chucky. A lot of dolls away, so maybe he just takes.
But why would he bring this little evil bastard with him?
It's at the bar.
I don't know. Oh, I just got a little.
Exactly. Get it.
Well, what's Santa gonna do? Walk in with Chucky? All right. Either I get a date, or he gonna kill everybody in here.
They said be with him.
The life, Steve. Man.
Mr. Otter, how you doing, Dave?
I'm doing fine, Steve.
Pleasure to meet you, sir.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
You performed at Super Bowl.
Yes, I did.
What you do?
Halftime performance at Super Bowl.
What you play?
I play trombone. Today?
Yes, today. In Charlotte, North Carolina, all of my classmates walked across the stage.
So, but you wasn't there?
No, sir. So I have a request. Would you allow me to walk across the stage and hand me my diploma?
Yes. 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 Okay, so let me, don't want you to do a long walk. Please welcome Sarah John.
I'm cold, and there are wolves after me.